If there's one thing the good people of Dillydale dislike, it's pests. Whether it's a mosquito buzzing in their ear on a hot summer night, ants stealing their picnic basket, or a gopher gnawing the tips off their turnips, these scoundrels truly bother the Mr. Men and Little Misses, particularly Mr. Fussy. But when you live next door to Mr. Messy, it's hard to avoid the occasional pest.
Mr. Messy. It is one thing to live next door to his untidiness. It is quite another for his untidiness to come and snatch my cake.
Hey, Mr. Strong! Mr. Fussy! You going on a safari?
Not exactly.
Yeah, Mr. Fussy called me and asked me to come help him catch a mouse.
That hideous little creature came over to my home from your side of the wall.
I have a mouse? So that's what's been happening to all my sock cheese.
Let me at him.
I don't understand how you can live in such a mess.
Ah, it's easy. If you want, I'll show you how.
Wait.
I think I'm going to faint.
The best thing to do is to speak their language. It confuses them.
Yo, cheep, 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 cheep.
Aw, pickles.
There it is. Don't let it get away.
Gotcha. Ah, or not.
Over here! He's coming after me!
Aw, double pickles.
Honestly, Mr. Strong, how hard can it be to catch a tiny mouse? And you, Mr. Messy, should be ashamed that this hovel of yours has allowed this pest to prosper.
Wanna play some checkers?
Sure.
Discarded bottle caps. Moldy mittens. Oh, it's messier up here than it is downstairs. I have a good mind to have this house condemned.
King me.
Gladly. Mouse, giant mouse. Looks like he caught the mouse.
Way to go, Mr. Fussy. So, you gonna king me or what?
Naughty here to tell you how you can be naughty too with Miss Naughty's Rent-A-Pest, where you can rent any number of pests for your mischief-making needs. Is your party boring? Well, it won't be with my swarm of mosquitoes. Just open the jar and watch as your guests do the mosquito dance. If you're looking for something really naughty, rent my basket of ants! They'll love it, and so will you! Want to do something naughty in someone's garden? Then rent one of my four-footed pests! So if you want a pest, and you want the best, come on down to Miss Naughty's Rent-A-Pest and tell them Miss Naughty sent you.
One place that you never want to find a pest is in your food at a restaurant. Especially if that restaurant is owned by Mr. Rude.
Where is that Mr. Rude?
Have patience, Mr. Grumpy. He's probably whipping up something wonderfully delicious in the kitchen.
Let's hope you're right, Mr. Happy.
Yeah, I'm so hungry I could eat this fly.
Mr. Quiet, watch where you're snapping that napkin.
What do you want?
To eat, for one. Why else would we come to your restaurant?
So, Mr. Rude, I have a question about this tomato salad. Is it good?
If you like that sort of thing.
Oh, I do. In fact, that's exactly what I'll have for lunch.
I'll make that too.
Too bad for you. I have no tomatoes.
Oh, well then, how about a cheese sandwich?
I have no cheese.
Then I'll have the cabbage.
Don't even dream about it.
Oh, what do you have?
Soup.
I love soup. Fine, bring us 3 bowls of soup.
I don't like your tone of voice.
Bean ball and lettuce soup? How interesting.
Oh, there's a fly in my soup.
This is awful.
You're telling me.
Oh, this soup isn't so bad. And just look at the size of this bean ball.
Almost as big as that fly.
Stop splashing your soup. Bad enough I have to eat this stuff. Don't need to wear it, too.
Oh, but there's a gross fly in it.
Good grief, Mr. Quiet. You should know better.
I think I got him.
Oh, come on!
Wait, what's this? Crackers? Oh, who puts crackers in bean ball soup? This is beyond horrible.
Oh, what are you squawking about?
This soup, it's terrible. I wouldn't even feed it to my dog if I had a dog. I think the soup's fantastic. Well, I don't.
Who asked you? You think you could do better?
I could make soup out of mud and moldy bananas, and it would be better than this.
Fine. You don't like my soup? Then you don't deserve my restaurant. Get out.
Don't have to ask me twice. Come on, fellas. We have a date with Liverwurst. Thank you, Mr. Rude. We had a wonderful meal. We'll have to do it again sometime.
Speak for yourself.
And don't come back.
Probably one of the most troublesome pests is the common wasp, which can deliver a terrible sting. Too bad poor Mr. Bump has the job of removing their nests.
How do I get rid of these wasps, Mr. Bump? I mean, I don't want them to be insulted or anything, but I just don't like them very much.
Well, Miss Sunshine, the only way to get rid of wasps is to get rid of the nest. But have no fear. Mr. Tickle and I will have this nest out of here in no time.
Oh, I can't watch.
Maybe it would be best if you went inside until we're through.
Oh, good idea.
What do we do first?
The most important thing is to approach the nest very slowly. You want to earn the wasp's trust.
You know what else would earn their trust? A good tickle.
No, Mr. Tickle, no!
See? A tickle is tons of fun! It was just one tiny tickle.
Yes, but wasps' nests aren't meant for tickling.
Anything like it.
What are you talking about?
The wasp nest. Mr. Stubborn, that's the biggest nest I've ever seen.
That is not a wasp nest. That is a piñata.
I love piñatas.
So do I, but that is not a piñata. If it was, it would be filled with candy, not hundreds of angry, stinging wasps.
I do not have wasps.
I'm afraid you do. I'll show you. Using my trusty smoker, which will put the wasps into a nappy nap while I remove the hive without any tickles.
Well, can I tickle you later?
When we're through.
You're wasting your time. That is not a wasp nest.
I don't know, Mr. Stubborn. I think Mr. Bump is right. It looks waspy.
Let me work my pinata!
No, Mr. Tickle, do something!
I knew it was a piñata! Wait! Who ate my candy?
And so you see, pests do pose a fair number of problems throughout Dillydale. But the Mr. Men and Little Misses don't let a little pest ruin their day. Because after all, one man's pest is another man's tickle.